Hello there, I'm Blackbright and I'm broadcasting out of the UK and welcome to my channel, returning subscribers. I got an audio today that I thought was quite interesting or controversial because when you're thinking about homophobia, it's such a sensitive subject and how do you respond, especially as a child. So I'm going to let you listen to the audio and then I'm going to just say my two pence worth. Hopefully not create too much of a fora, but yeah.
Hi, hi, is that Miss Sophie Lynch?
Yeah, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you?
I'm good. I just want to call about it today.
Yes, please.
Okay. So I just wanted to speak about something that happened in tutorial time this morning.
Okay.
So students were discussing, because in tutorial resources we kind of speak about lots of different topics, and today's topic was about the decision of Uganda introducing the death penalty for kind of aggravated homosexuality. Mm-hmm. And so Olivia's form tutor kind of was encouraging discussions and asking the students, what do you think about this? Do you agree with it? And then Olivia said, oh, it's their country. They could do what they like. I agree. Mm-hmm. And so Mr. Benet challenged her on that, mm-hmm. About why she felt that way. And then Olivia then proceeded to say that being gay is a sin, she was referring to. She said it's a sin. Mm-hmm. So...
Sorry.
So she said when she was challenged by her form tutor that by saying that being gay is a sin, that is a homophobic comment to make. Her understanding of being homophobic is hating gay people and kind of being violent or acts of hatred towards them. No, it's okay, no problem at all. But basically, because she was in tutorial time, mm-hmm. and Olivia has outwardly said in that tutorial time that being gay is a sin, mm-hmm. She has been given a day of 2 days in the inclusion room.
Why? Why? Why has she been? I'm sorry. Okay, sorry, carry on. I'm listening. Sorry.
So I'm just about to explain.
Okay, right.
I've had a conversation with her this morning,
yeah.
and I'll have another conversation with her at the end of the day today.
Okay.
Because we're trying to really explain to Olivia, you know, I said, break it down for me. What is a sin? Could you define what a sin is to me? And she said, oh, it's something kind of negative, it's something bad, and that if you do that, then you go to hell. And she explained it in that way. And so I was trying to make her understand that I completely respect her religious views, but by saying in the tutorial time that being gay is a sin, that is showing prejudice and it's saying a negative thing about being gay. Mm-hmm. And as a Christian school and a Christian academy, as you're aware, part of our ethos is being kind and accepting of others. Mm-hmm. And so you have to appreciate that in that form room, mm-hmm. you know, there may be students that are gay and they would feel quite uncomfortable mm-hmm. in that situation. Mm-hmm. And for any kind of homophobic language or racist language, it's the same. We give a sanction of 2 days, and that's the reason why she's got a sanction of 2 days.
Okay, all right. Have you finished, Miss Lynch?
Yeah, I finished.
Okay, all right. That Olivia is not having. She's not having inclusion. Right? First of all, right, she was asked, right, her opinion. And she gave her honest opinion. I, for one, do not encourage any form of discrimination, right? And again, when she said it's a sin, she's coming from a religious perspective, as opposed to, you know, okay, this is what I personally feel. Now, if Mr. Barney, is that his name, did not want yeah. an opinion, then he should not have asked her. So basically, right, and don't get me wrong, I do hear what you're saying, right? That there may be some pupils in the class that may be, you know, gay. I do get that. And they may feel offended, right? But a question was asked of her. And I'm sure in your tutorial classes, right, or just generally with your pupils, you encourage them to speak their mind, right? Now, if she wasn't asked, she would not have said anything. So it's not like she's gone and she's, you know, oh, you know, insulting, you know, left, right, and center, be it a black person, a gay person, or whatever sort of person, be it whatever. She's not doing that. She's giving her honest opinion, and she's being penalized for that. And it's coming from a religious background. Because if, I'm not sure if you're a Christian, right? Now, this is my take, right? I'm a Christian, and we know in the Bible it's a sin. Then again, I'm not God. God judges. That doesn't mean we cannot love everyone, gay, straight, or whatever. God judges. But she was asked a question. So why is she being penalized for answering a question honestly? So I'm sorry, but I'm refusing that she does not do any inclusion. It's not fair. It's not fair. Mr. Bernie should not have asked her that question. She's been saying to me for a while now. And you know, when she comes to me and she, oh, hold on, please. Let me finish speaking. Because you and I, we've talked about Mr. Bernie the last time we spoke. And even before then, Olivia comes to me and she says, oh, Miss Sabani, she doesn't like the way he behaves. He's always in her face, you know, and you know, and it makes her feel uncomfortable. Now, it's not even to do with Mr. Bani. It can be anyone. Olivia likes, she doesn't like it when people come into her space, even with her sister. You know, if her sister gets really, really close to her inner space, she gets easily irritated. You understand? And out of respect,
I think I'll stop it there because it kind of goes off track. But I think you get the general stance that both people are taking. Now, the definition of homophobia, number one, I was wondering if she'd even told the teacher that she was recording her, because you're not allowed to record someone without telling them. I don't think that teacher knew she was being recorded, and then she's using her name, her first name and her last name. So I'm not quite sure how we stand with that. But putting that aside, the definition of homophobia is dislike or unfair treatment of gay people, bias, discrimination, negative attitudes towards homosexual people and homosexuality, which may be manifested in discrimination, hostile responses or reactions. So by asking the school child her opinion, bearing in mind, we don't know her age, but bearing in mind that her opinion is just her view or judgment formed about homosexuality, but is not necessarily based on fact or knowledge, was the teacher goading her? Because if you ask an impressionable child a question, they're going to just speak it out uncensored. They wouldn't know how to put it forward diplomatically. They wouldn't have the emotional intelligence to make sure it comes out in a non-offensive way. So, she is, because she's a Christian child, and it's a Christian school, so it's a bit bizarre. But anyway, but a Christian child is likely to respond to that teacher's question, which I forget what the question was now. Well, she said homosexuality was a sin. I forgot what the question was. But anyway, but she's likely to respond in the context of what she has been taught in the Bible, but not necessarily from her own informed understanding. So how did that teacher expect her as a child to respond to that question in a large classroom, bearing in mind, you know, she has only a certain level of intelligence and maturity? Should some boundaries have been set before asking the question about how to respond so as not to offend? Now, if he had said, supposing it was, what do you think of gays? If he had said to her, listen, I'm going to ask you a question, Olivia, about gays, but please bear in mind, we have gays in the room, and bear in mind that while your religion might play an active role in the way you're thinking, I would like to hear your take on it, but try to be as sensitive as possible, or something like that. She would have been able to have time to think, as opposed to somebody just saying, what's your opinion on this? And you feel as though you are allowed to say anything you like. And then to be kind of really set upon because you haven't responded in a kind of diplomatic or mature way. So I think boundaries should have been set when he asked her the question and given her like a kind of, you know, some kind of cushioning. I also wondered whether her mother was right when she said her teacher should not have asked her her opinion if he didn't want an honest one, or whether it was the mother's responsibility to prepare children, her child, for questions like that and know how to respond. Personally, I probably would have said, I don't have an opinion. But I'm a mature adult because I know how sensitive the subject is, even talking about it on a very, very light level. It can create so many kinds of problems because it is such a sensitive subject. So I, if that was my daughter, and if your child is going to school, I mean, you have to warn them about these possible problems. Now, she's got 2 days in an inclusion room. I was trying to find out what an inclusion room is. And I was wondering if it, from what I looked up, it was a place where you learn about all cultural differences and stuff. So is she going to have 2 days in a room telling her about how she must be accepting of, whether it's homosexuality, whether it's disabled people, whether it's people of certain races and creeds and religions? Is that the purpose of the inclusion room? Was the child's understanding of homophobia correct? I mean, if we go by the definition in the Oxford Dictionary, it's quite wide. I mean, the daughter seemed to think she would be homophobic if she was saying, I hate gays, or, you know, she was violent towards them. That's her definition. So by speaking her opinion, I don't think she meant to insult or offend anyone, because, and she didn't consider herself as being homophobic either. So it's also, you know, when you're asking children these questions, you need to put it in context and you need to make sure they understand the question, and you know, they actually understand the word and the meaning of the word. You just don't throw it out there, because that's definitely going to cause problems. So at what age do children develop emotional intelligence? I mean, that varies. But you would need emotional intelligence to be able to respond to that question. So I think that is all I'm going to say for now. But I would appreciate your thoughts, having heard the video. I hope it came out okay. And my questions. And that's all for now. Bye-bye.